Okay, so to me, feminism is the equality between men and women. Not that women are better than men, it's just that they're completely equal.
Well, I believe feminism is when women believe that they can do anything they want to do and accomplish anything they want to accomplish in life.
When I think of feminism, I think of basically just equality among all genders, so like women having like the same rights as men do, like how it should be.
Bueno, es una mujer que se ocupa de ella misma, que quiere que reconozcan las personas el valor de la mujer. Eso es ser feminista.
Like, a lot of people that I talk to think that feminism is like this, like, gung-ho, women first, we are oppressed. Like, hear me roar, I am a woman. But I don't see feminism like that. I think feminism is an aspect of equality for all people. I feel like a lot of the things that women are oppressed for, men aren't, but there are a lot of things that men are oppressed for that women aren't. And like, you can't discount those things. But I think that it is super important as a woman, especially women going into ministry and working with youth, to empower women and girls to strive for the things that society may not be as welcoming to. So like equal pay and women going into the STEM field or even into ministry in a lot of places that's still not super accepted. And so pushing the boundaries and supporting other women in their strive to do that.
Feminism is the equality of both genders.
Yes, because I don't believe the Bible prohibits me to do what I think is right. According to my abilities for being a woman.
Well, I think, yes, you can be a feminist and Christian. I don't think it should matter what your religion is. You can be any religion, but specifically being Christian shouldn't stop you from being allowed to be a feminist because it's just looking for equality in everything.
Sí, se puede ser feminista y cristiana. Por eso yo creo que ser feminista es una de las formas que ahora las mujeres son pastoras. Es la igualdad entre los dos, que yo puedo hacer todo y respetar a mi esposo, a respetar lo que manda la Biblia como mujer, pero tener yo mi propia creencia de que la mujer no es que la Biblia en los tiempos aquellos ciertas cosas se le decían a las mujeres por lo que estaba pasando en la Biblia, pero muchas mujeres hicieron su rol de ser feminista y levantarse como Ruth, como Esther, no dejaron de ser feminista y también lucharon, hicieron cosas grandes para que se le tomó en cuenta. Entonces, yo no creo que la religión tenga que ver nada con ser feminista.
Yes, I think that you absolutely can. If you're looking at it in terms of supporting all people in all walks of life, I think that you need to have those kinds of attitudes and perspectives. I think also, like when you look in the Bible, like some of the first people who talked about Jesus after he died and was resurrected, they were all women, you know, and they were spreading the gospel before the disciples even were sent out to preach, you know. And I think first that solidifies the want for women in the church, in Christianity, but also definitely that call from God as Christians is to support all people and everything and lift people up and try to make sure that everyone is living into what they've been gifted, and how they can do that regardless of who they are or what gender they are.
Yeah. Yes, I think as a Christian, most of the time, people think that you have to follow the Bible literally or word for word. But in my Christian beliefs, I tend to not follow the Bible word for word, but look and see like what the head of the Christians are doing or what the priests or pastors are doing as well.
You definitely can be feminist and Christian. I guess when I think about it, from what I've learned, I think that Jesus was a feminist. Like, he had the people who found that he was risen from the dead be women. He had them spreading the news, and he treated them as equal. So I think that looking at feminism from a Christian perspective makes so much sense.
My experience was in the church. I grew up Catholic, and when I went to elementary school, I learned how to be an altar server. So I was very active in altar serving and part of the church. And then as I got to high school, we changed priest, and he was very against female altar servers. So that kind of changed my perspective on what the Catholic Church or the Christian Church believes about females and power in the church.
Bueno, ha sido buena, hay muchas cosas que no me gustan, pero la tolero. Hay muchas cosas en la iglesia que hay veces que pastores o miembros tienen sí a las mujeres como en un segundo plano, como todo es hombre, para ciertos cargos importantes, para ciertas cosas que hay que hacer. Pero es como te digo, la religión la creó el hombre en la iglesia. Y todavía permanece ese machismo en la iglesia. En toda la iglesia permanece un machismo. Muchas mujeres se han destacado y se están levantando sutilmente, pero lo están haciendo. Y eso es lo que cada una de nosotros debemos, en lo que creemos. Como te digo, la iglesia es una institución creada por hombres y ellos van a poner sus reglas, no siempre lo que la Biblia dice. Entonces tú debes pararte por lo que tú crees. En la misma iglesia donde se levanta todo eso, usted se para y tiene su opinión y tiene su modo de pensar y reaccionar y hacer cosas en base a la Biblia, pero ser usted. Ser tú, no dejar que influya tanto en la vida de la mujer a la iglesia, porque en aquellos tiempos eran distintos. Ahora las mujeres tenemos roles de hombre y seguimos siendo mujeres, porque antes había sumisión y había todo, pero no. Era, por ejemplo, la sumisión de la mujer someterse al marido como el marido se somete a la iglesia, pero ahora los mismos que te quieren someter no están sometidos, ellos primero. Y por eso es que se ha levantado esta rebeldía de la mujer.
My experience in the church, I was raised in the CRC tradition. My grandpa is a pastor in the CRC, and I was involved in youth groups and Bible studies. But then, kind of as I was discovering that I'm queer, I was going to a conservative Christian school, and I was consistently told by my school, by pastors, by people in my church community, that I was wrong, or that God didn't make me right, or that I'm sinful or condemned, and that just didn't sit well with me, and I got really angry. So I've left the church now. I am kind of trying to find my place with religion and spirituality as a queer person in the United States, so that's been interesting. But as of right now, I think I just still hold a lot of anger and resentment towards the church.
So my mom is a pastor in the Reformed Church of America, and she's the first woman who was ordained in her classes, which is kind of a big deal. And so I think growing up, I saw a lot of women in ministry, a lot of women who were really good leaders and really kind of pushed me forward in the thought that feminism isn't just like, you know, like, I'm an angry lady, you know. There's like a point to it, and it's not just for women. But yeah, so I've never personally felt like being a woman in the church was ever a bad thing, because I was always surrounded by a lot of people, a lot of women who were in the church and very involved in doing things that weren't just being the pastor's wife, and you know. But when I came to Hope, I became friends with someone who's a Baptist, and she was very much like, women don't belong in the pulpit, but they need to be whispering into their husbands' ears about what to do. And that was like a shock for me, because I didn't, like, I knew people didn't support women in the church, but I had never encountered it, and it kind of shook me a little bit. But I think that all in all, the churches and Christian organizations that I've been involved with have never, the institutions themselves have never oppressed women in any sort of way. I've always kind of seen women in leadership, and it's always been good.
I think it's been a positive experience. As a Christian woman, I have been able to work in ministry, in various capacities. Like, I have been a teacher in women's retreats. I have been a children's director, where I have led a group of Bible study teachers within the kids ministry. And what else? There's has been a lot of opportunities for growing as an adult through retreats and conferences and things like that.
Okay, so in my church, I personally haven't experienced anything that was alarming by any means. I've always been very welcomed, and everyone's been very, very nice. Recently started going to a new church this past summer at my hometown, and I didn't grow up with like a big church background, and was kind of like worried at first, like, okay, this is very new to me, like, what am I gonna do, how am I gonna experience it? But everyone was super nice, and all the teachings have never thrown any red flags for me about being biased towards like women in general or just any people. And so I've experienced some pretty nice churches in general. So I think some of my biggest struggles have been thinking about like what jobs are like quote unquote considered more for women. And so when I was doing my first track as like pre-med coming into college, I was thinking, okay, like, you know, it might be a hard field to get into just because like it kind of is male dominated. It's changing a lot now because there's like a big push for like equality, but it's still not like there all the way. And so when I switched to nursing, I was afraid that, I mean, I'm just doing what is considered like a predominantly female job, but it's encouraging to see males in the profession too. And then I think one of the biggest struggles I face is like the sexuality of women, and just like if you're at a club, like guys feel it's okay to like come up behind you and start dancing, or will like catcall you on the streets. And so I think that's one of the biggest struggles I face.
I think as a woman in today's society, some of my biggest struggles are safety, such as like walking home after class when it's late, or proving myself to a world that is run by men. So like trying to get higher up in a job when as women we have the glass ceiling. also education, I think, is a big thing, and then pay, which is also, again, about, like, proving yourself to a world that is powered by men.
As a woman, I feel like there's aspects where I struggle and aspects where I know that I have a lot of privilege. I was raised in a family where it's a family of very strong, opinionated women who are supported by wonderful, also equally strong and opinionated men. So I didn't grow up seeing a lot of the inequality. And like my parents and grandparents always worked very well together. So I think as a woman, I struggle seeing other women being put down or seen as less than. And I think that it's hard looking at the world the way it is right now. Seeing how much we've grown, but also seeing how much problems women around the world face, and how there's still so much lack of equality for women, and the way that men can abuse the power that they have because we live in a patriarchal society.
Se trata la mujer inferior. Y la mujer tiene que siempre estarse todo el tiempo parándose por los derechos y para que se les reconozca y para que se les tome en cuenta. Eso es una de las cosas más importantes porque donde quiera que va, trabajo y en todas partes, a la mujer no se trata la misma igualdad que se trata al hombre. Aunque uno esté preparado como está el hombre y educada, trabaja para sustentar haciendo el papel de hombre y de mujer y no se toma en cuenta nada de eso, siempre quieren tenerla sometida a la voluntad de hombres. Y eso es uno de los mayores problemas que no, a la mujer se nos presenta.
The tampon tax. I'm just gonna put that out there right first. I don't think that's right. yeah, I don't know. I think media plays a big part in it. I think a lot of the time you just see men who are in power, and sometimes it's hard to have all of the confidence in being a leader as a woman. Not feeling safe all the time, I think, is a big one too. Like walking outside at night in the dark is a little bit frightening, which is sad. And like in certain situations, so like I wouldn't go to a bar by myself because I wouldn't want somebody to like make advances that I wasn't comfortable with, and I'm like not respecting that or like that. Yeah, I think those would be the biggest things for me.
Well, around the area of being feminist, I think one of my struggles has been having a husband, even though I know that I can do anything I would want to do, but I still need like support from another person. To maintain the lifestyle that I have. I believe that's the only struggle that I have, just being a widow and not having a husband at this time in my life.